We should have downloaded Twitch on your phone so we could look at it. It's all good. We'll get to watch the gameplay.
Hi everyone! 4 months ago, we started the diff-rip.
The diff-rip?
We started diff-rip, an app that uses cloud-based sustainable durian farming to restore the barren forests, indigenous durian groves, to create sustainable foodways practices. And meanwhile, with the power of 13 to 20 hearts, we have engaged the divine beasts in a cloud-based disruptive campaign. And therefore, we are bringing equitable, sustainable foodways practices back to Hyrule.
This is too much.
Hi, Daisy. Daisy, you there?
I can't believe what I'm seeing on screen right now. Oh my gosh. It's always something new on this stream,
yep.
Isn't it?
Hi.
Yes, the most important Public Humanities Foodways project in existence continues. Yeah.
Also, I'm the vice president of gaming for the Durian Fruit Reclamation Project. We also have the president of the Durian Fruit Reclamation Project on stream. And TJ, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
TJ, you heard we were playing Zelda again. You just wanted to give us recipes. You're not even the formal guest. You're not getting interviewed. You just
get to hang out now.
You just want to hang out? Yeah.
Just hanging out, and I've got my son Eli with me. He is the Breath of the Wild like expert. He is the reason why we're here with recipes. And he had a lot of fun watching our stream, and he was really excited about when I showed him the promotion for tonight's stream that you were playing Breath of the Wild again and that you were doing recipes.
Yeah,
and I think too it was a great opportunity to build some support around durian fruit reclamation and making sure that people understand that this
how
is
important
a, this,
the durians
this is an
are
important, serious,
disruptive
tragedy.
Yeah.
Limited resource.
It's a liminal space.
We
really
must preserve. Yeah.
I mean, what other fruit can give you up to 20 extra hearts? I mean, it tastes like garlic at the same time. That's right.
Yeah. I always say the durian tastes like the inside of a pierogi.
You know, I think, yeah.
Yeah.
A sweaty, two-day-old pierogi? Yes.
I mean, how else do you eat them? Like, in a church basement 12 hours later. That's how I know them. you want to get some, first things first. Daisy,
yeah, let's...
you want to meet the last great fairy tonight.
I want to meet the final... thick fairy.
The final thick.
It's fairy. Time.
And then,
I have been waiting for this. We need it. We need it to happen.
And our guest, Mackenzie Kwok, she wants to, she wants to do some cooking. So I figure we're going to kill two birds with one stone, and we are going to, go hunting for some gourmet meat that we can cost effectively sell for money to give to the great fairy. So we're going to put on our snow gear, go to the mountains, and go for a hunt. We'll get enough rare steaks, the only pun I'll ever make on this channel, to get some money off of them, and then hopefully meet a great fairy before 9:45. So
that sounds awesome.
Sounds cool. Hello to everyone in chat. Hello to everyone who's come to our keynote address for Diff-Rip. And I hope you donate to our please consider donating to our project to sustain the forest, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, our durian fruit reclamation project could use donations.
I mean, the fact that durian fruit's just restricted to Farron Forest, which is a very small part of Hyrule. And
cultivation is very difficult.
It is.
Yeah. Daisy, it's time to go back to our durian grove.
Yes, let's do it.
For the memories.
Do you like
the memories?
Dom, do you like risotto?
Like, personally?
like risotto.
In my personal life?
I think I make
a pretty good risotto, yeah. You can make
slice of the cooker risotto on Breath of the Wild?
Oh, that oh.
Was that too meta?
No, not at all.
So TJ, these guys are my favorite.
Race. Oh yeah, Daisy hates that I'm killing their favorite the
I love them.
Zalos?
Yeah,
yeah.
Daisy's favorites.
I love
Zalos.
Nobody.
Daisy.
I love
who.
Them. It's me. I like them.
Welcome back. Welcome back.
Wow.
To the Farron.
Eli, get in here. I'll fight you. Wish I was playing this game in real life. We could go at it.
So, Daisy, last time we went to the Durian Grove, we kind of got to the Durian Grove, and that was like, or we kind of, we went down to the stable and like cooked them, right? But we did not,
yes.
Climb this, this here cliff face. Correct?
No, we did not. We did not.
Should I show you what's up there, or do you want to go to the mountains?
Well, wait, what's up there? Something cool up there?
There's a
couple
cool things.
Gonna be another one of those little guys.
Maybe. Oh, it's right. Oh.
It's another one of those little guys. Oh.
Headshot.
Whoa.
Did I do it?
Damn.
What do I got?
Damn.
What did I get?
You're getting good.
Raw prime meat. Very good. Hey, guess what? It's one of these guys. Oh, you stepped on me. Hi. Hey, bud. Stand still. Oh, no, not a durian tree. Oh, you harvested a durian for me. But you did it in an unsustainable way.
Nice.
No, it's
true.
He needs to do a growth, okay? not a no growth. Oh. Dumbass.
Hiya, hiya. Ooh.
How am I doing? I'm good on weapons. Let's see what else you give me. I want your toes. Give me your toes, big man.
Give me those toes.
Durian, apple, some wood.
Sorry.
Your toe. You know.
You want to watch the stream again? Alright.
More durians.
Don't you get like teeth too? Like fingernails or something?
Yep. Yeah, just regular cool shit. Can I do it?
You're a little bit quiet. Eli, just a heads up.
We're sharing an AirPod.
Oh, that's what it is.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so I fought a Hinox. Oh, look, it's our boy Farosh.
Oh, they're fun. They're sweet. Shoot them in the eyeballs.
Well, we did a Hinox, but we got this guy. Oh, I think he sees me.
No, that guy.
Oh, he sees me. Oh, I should say hi.
No, run, you're gonna die.
What? No, they're my favorite.
What? You can do it.
I'm going to prove I'm on his side. I'm here.
No, listen.
He's gonna win.
They're smart. They will. No.
No, I'm one of you.
That's good. It's good for you guys.
Yeah, just get on your powerful armor.
Look, I'm your cousin. Eh.
Eh. Your fifth move.
You're totally like a Lionel Mini-Me.
Yeah, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. I don't have a lot of arrows.
Just the two of us.
Hey, buddy. Hey, you like that dragon? Me too. I like that dragon a lot. He's just staring at me like, who the hell is this? Oh my god.
What if this is like a Bugs Bunny thing and it backfires and he actually falls in love with you?
Oh my god. Well, seeing as we did Gerudo Desert last week, it would be appropriate.
It would be cool.
You should be wearing your Gerudo gear right now, that you could be the girl line.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's got like no defense.
Yes! Oh!
Here. Yeah. When Bugs Bunny would dress up like a girl Lionel, like, yes. Did you think he was
Oh my
hot?
God.
Yeah, me neither.
Totally.
Totally, me neither.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I think he's a little bit mad about. A little bit mad about that.
Uh-oh.
He's excited.
Oh.
Yeah.
Somebody else.
Hey, bud.
Yeah.
You happy? You happy to see me? God,
oh,
is that a
no.
ridiculous spear, or are you just happy to see me?
It's not gonna end well.
What do you mean it's not gonna end well?
You have no faith in Dom's ability to fight the monster.
I do. Okay, he ate durian fruit. Never mind. I see that he's got the
power of durian.
He has the power of durian.
Yeah, here at the durian reclamation project.
The power of durian.
Here, I'm breaking out the spin to win device. Ooh,
spin to win.
Oh,
look at that.
You gotta get the fury attack. That's the only way.
Urbosa's fury.
No, you get a, like,
Oh, the flurry. Yeah. Yeah, of course. This ain't my first Lionel.
Yeah.
This ain't my first Lionel rodeo.
Hey, Rice.
Oh, y'all are fighting it together.
Oh.
That's so sweet.
Oh, it's a white one.
Eli's fighting it in the daytime.
I'm trying to...
Hey, he keeps making rice for me. Oh.
Oh, that was not good.
Come here,
so much rice. Look at all these ingredients.
Yeah, I could just be giving Daisy some good recipes.
That's true. That's true. You could be doing that while I'm
good. Yeah.
A touch preoccupado.
Yeah. What do we got here? So we went through some of the desserts.
Do you want a dessert or two?
My Hylian
silk. Well, you were telling me some desserts before.
Yeah, let's do.
What
you want to do, like?
Yeah, what are some recipes?
Let's do an egg tart. Like egg tarts.
That sounds pretty good.
Sure.
All right, it's one bird egg, goat butter.
Oh, that backfired.
Cane sugar. And the wheat.
Okay.
And then, how about a crepe? How about a honey crepe?
Ooh, a honey crepe. Wow.
You gotta get the bee honey. You know,
I got some bee honey on me. Yeah.
And then cane sugar.
Okay.
Fresh milk.
Lots of sugar.
Oh.
A bird egg and a brace of wheat. Is it a brace of wheat? I just made that up.
A brace?
Is that the right number?
Is that a unit of measurement?
Like, what?
Alright,
I was looking at this.
Oh.
No, I just said that.
Where are we at?
Let's see. How about some crab risotto? Would that be good? Is that or salmon risotto?
Oh, crab risotto would be great.
Yeah. All right. So any crab. So there's like blue, red. There's all these different crabs. So any crab. Rock salt.
Gotcha, Flexitron. Thank you.
Hylian rice and goat butter, and you've got crab risotto.
Oh, I was trying to mount him. I flew too close to the sun.
Rip.
That's the
point. What about clam chowder? Are y'all chowder fans? You like chowder?
I can get down with some chowder.
Chowder? Some chowder.
Chowder. That's you need a hearty blue snail.
Okay.
Goat butter.
I don't think I have
fresh
that.
Milk. And wheat. You'll have to, if you need butter, there's a lot, butter's found in a lot of different markets.
Okay.
Okay.
The Gerudo market has butter, right?
Yeah, I think every market has it, yeah.
Oh, got it.
Yeah, Goron can't have butter because it's too cold.
Oh, sure, it'll curdle.
I shot my Wild Guardian arrow and it evaporated.
Which what?
And you're getting prime meat, right?
Trying.
A lot of prime meat. Trying. Yep. Working on it when you're not fighting Lionels.
We're not fighting Lionels. It's a Lionel. How scary could it be?
How about some gourmet
meat? Ooh, yeah. Thank you, Flexitron. A gourmet what now?
Gourmet meat stew.
Oh, I'm on fire. Oh, fairy.
Or prime meat stew.
Gourmet meat stew sounds great.
Gourmet meat stew, you need the raw gourmet meat. You need fresh milk.
I ran into that.
You need goat butter, and you need wheat.
Spin to win. I'm on fire.
Milk, butter, wheat. Yep.
Spin to win.
I need to eat something for the... Okay. I was on fire a little bit there, but it's all better.
What would you, Eli, what would you cook with the gourmet meat? Like, what kind of dish would you cook?
Okay, so if it's a honey hack, if you make, like, a cracked set of meat skirt, it's all with gourmet meat, they sell for, like, a lot. They sell on them.
So, okay, so get the gourmet meats, do 5 gourmet meats on a skewer.
Okay.
And they sell for a lot. So they're
that's what I'm trying to, that's the idea. That's the gameplay.
That's what we want to do.
That's the money hack.
We need to get a lot of money.
Yeah, that's your money hack. So yeah, get a bunch of gourmet meat, skewer them.
Ooh! Oh, thank you, Deathlorus.
Look at all these gift subs coming in.
I'm gonna hit you in the face. Oh, I was a little too close. I'm not used to him doing the fire thing. That's new. Hello, Luomi.
He's got that stupid spear.
I know the spear ones are so much more of a hassle. Oh no! Block Link! Yeah! Oh, come on. I get him? Style points for breaking the axe against his face? Yeah? We doing this?
Oh, nice!
Yeah!
Yeah!
That's what I want.
Nice.
Cool, shock arrows, Lionel horns.
Have you gotten the royal horse yet?
Yes! Her name is Motifa. Yes. Her name is Motifa.
The chat named her Motifa?
Yeah, chat named her Queen Motifa. What's her middle name?
Oh my gosh, Queen... What is it, folks? Is it Queen Motifa Emergence? No.
Queen Motifa... God, I can't remember a horse's middle name. Can you believe that?
What's our horse's middle name?
Alright, we gotta find some game up on the side of this, here mountain, Daisy.
Well,
hell yeah, let's go.
So, anyway, we're, so I'll see y'all tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow, TJ. And thank you so much for stopping by
I've got the
executive director of the Durian Fruit Reclamation Project.
You know, and just to remind folks, you know, your donations mean so much to us and so much to the Durian Forest and the people.
Your gift subs mean so much to the Durian Forest.
Yes.
Yeah, people depend on the Durian Forest to fight Lionels. Where would we be without Durian?
Lionels. Yeah. Yeah, every bit is one Durian tree that's been planted in reclamation.
Thank you for saving 1,000 trees, T-Papas.
Yeah.
Oh, that might be gourmet. That might be gourmet meat that I just made there.
Durian fruit.
Is this gourmet?
All right. We'll see you kids later.
All right.
Bye.
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 It was TJ. So happy you stopped by, and you'll see him tomorrow night. And now it's time for me and Daisy to hunt the mountains a little bit until Mackenzie shows up. Hi, Mandolin. What's going on? Oh, speaking of which, hey, shh. Oh my gosh. There we go. This is gonna be. Oh, okay. We got one gourmet. Yeah, meat reacts only. I'm gonna. Can I get this?
Flaming meats.
Oh, those are gourmet. Very good. Those are gourmet.
Oh, so gourmet. Oh, I don't want you. Just the little pupper.
That's a big, scary wolf.
Wolves are strong, sexy, and fearless. Anything below gourmet is an insult.
What was the second one?
Apparently.
What was the second one?
Anything.
Strong, fearless.
Of the three.
You said strong and fearless. What's
sexy.
The other one? Mmm, sexy.
Sexy. Interesting. It is sexy.
Who was that? Was it Fritz the cat in the chat?
Interesting take.
Now, this guy.
I don't think you can. They're just too freaking cute. Oh yeah, this guy though.
This big I don't know what the actual name of this in game is, but I've been calling him a woolly rhino.
I mean,
did I do it? Did I do it?
Aww.
Oh my god. Oh, it got frozen. Okay, it's now icy gourmet meat because a gust of wind came through.
Oh my god, too cold. Oh yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh
my god.
Shit.
You coming right for me?
Oh my. Oh no. Yes.
But weirdly,
oh no.
More scared of the Octorok.
Yeah.
Icy again.
Don't shoot in the butt. That's where the good steak is. No, if you shoot it in the butt, that's when you get bad steak.
No. But I get what Jared is getting at because Smidge Whisk is saying you shoot it in the butt, you ruin the steak.
Damaging.
You make Salisbury steak instead of like a New York Strip or something, instead of a porterhouse. Fun fact.
It's true.
Oh, you're a beauty.
Things.
How many points?
You learn things about this world.
How many points on this bad boy?
Oh. I don't like this hunting game anymore.
What?
16. Oh.
Gotta get it before it freezes. Meat rolling down the hill.
Get it. Look at your... Oh, he got it before you. Mackenzie will be here soon.
Wear low-cut jeans and look at my McGutters.
My McRib.
Yeah,
Mackenzie. Talk about McGutters.
Mackenzie's having a little bit of a situation. Needs to get a key from a roommate, but should be on the stream in no time. First of all, don't. I have an announcement.
Okay. is the announcement?
Oh, I forgot we were still in. Hold on.
What?
Don't ever put me
quick. Beep, 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 beep.
Don't ever.
Announcement from DFRP.
Don't ever put me in a situation. All right.
No situation.
No situations, please. Oh.
None.
I get him? Do not put me in a situation. Please perceive me. Oh, no, the wind. It's going to freeze it. It's going to freeze it.
Ah, go fast. Ah. Oh. Yes. Chat has put you in a situation.
You cannot put me in a situation.
You cannot. I cannot be contained.
I cannot be contained within a situation. I love Animal Crossing in the winter.
Yeah. That was fun. I do not like the snow boys.
Whoa, no, I love the snow boys.
I could never make a perfect
snow boy. So much
fun. They're cute, but I could, and they were so mean. And I could never make a good snowboy. Well, I also had to clear like a huge chunk of my island to even make it work. Ugh.
Rolling. Oh, frozen. Prime. It's not the one I remember.
I also look forward to Skyrim Flexitron. Flexitron, I'm gonna be an Argonian, but you can help me develop what they look like. But I have to play a lizard. There's only one way to play. It's playing as lizard.
Does the ice gym in Pokemon X and Y count? X and Y has an ice gym, right?
I think that probably counts.
Oh.
I think it counts.
Beautiful. As long as it doesn't freeze. There we go. There we go. There we go. There we go.
Nice.
Look away, Daisy.
I can't watch! Don't do it.
I did it. Oh, good
I
ones,
can
good
hear
ones.
It. I can hear it yelp.
Good ones.
I can hear it yelp. I can't wait until my Ooh. Computer comes in this summer Ooh. And you and I can trade off who's doing the stream. And we can play all kinds of games.
I have an idea.
I cannot wait.
I have an idea for best snow level. Are you ready for this? This might be non-traditional, but does any of like the mid-2000s Madden games inevitably play Brett Favre's Packers at home in the playoffs? I'm still surfing. Does that count going to Green Bay in Madden? Basically a snow level.
I mean, is it one of the best ones?
The Packers were always real good in like Madden 04, 05, like when the series was real good. So it always felt like kind of the closest thing it would give you to a boss fight. I dare you. I will spin to win you so bad.
Spin to win.
To answer your distinction, James Dalton Bell, I think that would mean you just not palette swapped, but you need like atmospherics and like cold buffs, and I think that means playing the pack in Lambo counts as a real snow level.
wait, I think wait. Our guest has joined us.
I heard something. Is that a guest?
Coming through?
Hello.
Hello.
Mackenzie, you there?
Hello. We can hear you.
Hi.
Oh, God. Hello, everybody.
Hi. It's Mackenzie Kwok, everyone. Coming all the way from Brooklyn, New York.
Brooklyn, New York. Fun fact.
America.
Hello.
Okay.
Look at this outfit. I love it.
So much better.
Okay, great.
Look at what?
Okay. This fit.
Oh,
it's
me?
Crazy.
Wait, me or Link?
Yeah. Link.
Okay.
Can't see
it. Oh. I might be in a suit.
You'll have to see Dom after.
Oh,
yeah, Dom is wearing a suit.
Oh, nice, Dom.
Yeah. It's for because we had a address to the shareholders of the Durian Fruit Reclamation Project earlier.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. I think it went pretty well. We got nice. We got 1,000 bits.
Wow. Is that a lot in the game?
In game that's real life.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, my appeal for bits to get more durians in our inventory worked for some reason.
Oh, sweet.
No, but we're hunting moose right now. Turn around.
Oh, my God. I can't shoot
you.
I see.
I don't want to shoot you in the butt. And I ate my sneaky steak. I ate my snake wrapped in sneaky flowers to have minimal footsteps in the snow. Yeah, I don't make crunchy noises in the snow anymore.
Oh, that's
okay.
Good to know.
Okay.
Okay. Here, okay.
Wait.
Okay.
Here's my moment.
Wow! Thank you for your life.
And I gotta grab it. Yes. Thank you for
your.
You gotta. You also gotta grab it before it freezes. We've learned.
It can freeze.
Yes, it can. Well, if you eat the frozen meat, it'll help you when you're in the desert. It'll cool you off in the desert.
Oh, how nifty!
I know.
That's so cool. So if you eat really hot food here, can you do that? You just put it over a fire and then you're warm?
More like eating spicy food.
It's more...
Yeah,
it's closer to eating like spicy food will make you warm.
If you eat hot peppers, you'll be fine.
Sweet.
Hey, Mackenzie, tell the stream a little bit about yourself now that you are officially on the call.
Yes, hello, my name is Mackenzie. I am a freelance folklorist. And in the field that folklore that I do, it's like arts administration folklore. Mm-hmm. So basically I jump from project to project, supporting traditional artists. So people who do anything from like basket weaving to Chinese paper cutting to for this festival I'm working on called Egg Rolls, Egg Creams and Empanadas, food making, and like people who play games in the parks in New York City. So it's kind of a like a catch-all term for people who can advocate for traditional arts in the state of New York.
Great. Dude, you're doing great work there.
What? Did these snowballs move?
That was a lizard that was hiding in the snow. And Daisy's in like a bit of, what would you call it? Like a complex, a mood. Daisy, I think officially, wants Link to lose and wants the lizards to claim Hyrule. And they want lizard rights and lizard independence. Ooh, I got hit pretty hard there.
I think it's time for the lizards to fully take over Hyrule. They are an oppressed people.
They're made of Ganon's malice. They are made of Ganon's malice. I don't
know
how
else to tell you that. Okay, it's in the same way that like this is the same way that like orcs are an oppressed people, okay? This is why I stan orc, because
again, the last ring bearer.
They are being used by the evil.
No, they're not being used. They are okay. James Dalton Bell said in the chat, they are literal, they are the literal manifestation of evil in this world.
Hmm.
Okay, good.
I don't know.
Gourmet!
You don't want to give evil a chance?
Gourmet! Oh my god, it literally is Gourmet. Icy Prime, raw Gourmet.
Yeah, so the Gourmet. The Gourmet meat we're gonna skewer up and sell for Buco Dolores, so that Daisy can meet that last fairy that you're so excited about.
The last, final, thickest fairy.
Here's the thing, not just the fairies. This game has like, this game is like Drake. She said I'm obsessed with thick women, and I agree. This game like loves thick women. We just got through like the Amazon city in the desert that was all like women with giant thighs and six packs.
Oh my god!
It was pretty awesome.
They cannot be stopped.
Yeah, yes. They cannot.
They cannot.
I'm out of arrows. Do you think I should head back to a stable so I can buy some arrows, Daisy?
Do you need how? Okay. What? Well, how much do you need?
I don't really know.
Do you think you need more?
More meat?
You've got 2,780 rupees right now. Yeah, do you think you need more meat to sell? Like,
probably.
Do you think that'll be enough?
Probably.
Or I mean, to cook with.
Let's do our first round of cooking while Mackenzie
talks
with us about,
and then come back. Yeah.
About foodways research. Why not?
Yeah.
Why not kill two birds with one hearth?
Let's cook.
With one stove. Yeah.
Yeah.
Where am I going? I'm going. Where should I cook? Where am I cooking, Daisy? Which part of we can teleport anywhere? Which part of the world should I cook in?
Well, you're in the freezy zone. Why don't you be in the warm zone?
Oh, there's zones.
You want to go to the desert?
I'm up here in the. Should we go to the desert?
Let's go to the desert.
The desert's got a real good kitchen. Okay, and of course.
Yeah,
Mackenzie, it's only women allowed inside the Gerudo City, so I'm gonna have to change so I can blend in.
Wow.
Yeah.
Look at how they make groups here. I like it. Look at this loading.
Meat.gov? Is that that better be a real thing?
Oh my god. I hope it is.
So while I get into my while I get dressed up like a beautiful girl, Mackenzie, can you tell me and Daisy and the chat really about, you mentioned the egg roll, egg cream, and empanada in that order festival?
Yep, in that order, festival, yes. Yeah.
Oh,
so
here, this is who I was talking about. Here are the guards. Oh, hello, Marina. She's very big.
She's large.
She's quite big.
Oh, sick.
Yeah,
she's
yeah.
She's got great moves.
And I mean, it's the whole city is... whole city's looking like this.
Beautiful. Yeah. I love this place.
Hell of a place, honestly.
Yeah. Oh, look at this place has a lot going on.
It really does. Oh.
You can do some
magic. I can get a white one.
Whoa.
So tell us a bit about the festival that you're working on right now.
Yeah, so the festival Egg Rolls, Egg Creams, and Empanadas has been around for like 20 years now.
Ooh, cool.
Yeah, it's usually like a one-day block party right by the museum at Eldridge Street where it's run out of.
Oh, tell the people about the museum at Eldridge Street.
The museum at Eldridge Street is a landmark synagogue. Right. It's just been restored not too long ago. It's really, really beautiful. And what began as sort of like a Jewish cultural site in the Lower East Side sort of expanded to look at larger Lower East Side culture. So Egg Rolls, Egg Creams, and Empanadas looks at the Chinese, Jewish, and Puerto Rican and Dominican communities of the Lower East Side, looking at sort of like the arts that come about there, the games that are played. Every year when it's like in person, there are booths for like paper cutting, Jewish paper cutting, Chinese paper cutting, Mexicante masks, which are like Puerto Rican paper mache masks. There's musicians, there's bomba en plena groups, there's klezmer dance, and there's like a Chinese opera or a Chinese folk group. They're all going to be on Zoom this year, but which is a little bit of a bummer, but also really cool that we get to sort of be super creative in who we get to talk to and who sort of gets to have the spotlight on different themes in the festival. So basically, there are four components to the festival. There's food, obviously.
Obviously. That's why we're here tonight.
Obviously. That's the best part of the festival.
And speaking of food, if I can distract you for 1 second. Yes, chat. Meet a stream is when we get 100 subs and I speed eat a hot dog. Make it happen.
Wow.
All right, Mackenzie, you were saying?
That was a juicy little skewer.
Thank you.
I was saying you should come for the hot dog eating portion of it. Oh, we'll make one for you.
Wait, is there?
No, that's not a thing. It can't be. But it says food and then music and performance is going to be sort of like the second theme. And then games and cultural exchange, which in the past has been like Mahjong. And this thing called Nine Man.
What did you say between Mahjong and Nine Man? Because you cut out.
Oh, handball.
Handball. Awesome.
Handball. And just sort of talking about other games that have been played there, like stickball or dice. Anything else that people can play in a park, like old people sitting on a little table or young people playing soccer or everything. Mm-hmm. And then the last one is folk arts, which I guess in the world of arts admin, it basically is just like arts that are tied to a culture and that you learn with community.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have.
I'd probably agree with that in the world of folklore for the most part.
I think so, too. Yeah. I think it can get dicey when you talk about folk art versus not folk art, but we can have that conversation. But yeah, we're looking at, we have a Chinese paper cutter who's also a dancer. We have a Jewish paper cutter.
Nice,
the mask maker. Yeah, lots of cool stuff there.
Cool. And when is that? When is that, by the way?
Yeah, so that's going to happen every Sunday in June. Every Sunday there's going to be about an hour and a half of Zoom programming.
This is a recurring feast, so to say.
This year this is a recurring feast, every Sunday dinner. And there's going to be like some films and stuff sprinkled in and out.
Awesome. What else? Do you have any requests on what you want to see me cook right now?
What do you do?
Well, of course you want to see this, of course. You want to see the durians, as we
do. Yeah. Have you all tried durian?
I've tried durian. I've tried durian once. I've had what?
Earlier, Dom said that a durian tastes like the inside of a pierogi.
Oh my god!
Yes, it is. It's a pierogi that's been sitting in a. And someone said a pierogi that's been sitting there for a while, and I'm like, yeah, most of my pierogies are like in the crock pot in a church basement all day. So that. So Mackenzie, I just made a whole thing of hearty simmered fruit with my 5 durians, and watch my. Okay, you see my HP? You see my hearts?
Huh?
Watch this. Oh, I'm so energized. I can tackle if I could.
Oh my god.
I can tackle anything now.
You can do whatever you want.
Yeah, what are you feeling? What would you eat right now if you could eat anything this little elf has foraged?
Oh my goodness. I just think it's so cool to see, like, wait, what did you say? Mushrooms can make you have powers, or little plants? Something with energizing juice. Oh, my stream cut out.
Oh, you're good.
But it's happening, I know.
Yeah, I was about to say durian mochi, I think, was the first time I had durian. James Dalton Bell, remember? Oh, first time I had a durian was durian mochi. I've had a durian, like a piece, a slice, a forkful of durian.
Forkful? Yeah.
Yeah. I'm trying to look at the recipes that TJ was giving us at the beginning of the stream. Chat, if you play Zelda and you've got some good good recipes, hit me up. And also, what do I do with the monster extract?
You can go. I think you can buy milk. I think you need goat milk.
I don't think they. I don't think they drink milk in the desert. Is what I'm saying.
Oh.
Like, I don't think there's milk here.
Oh, that's interesting. You
that might be true.
Yeah, they've got.
Yeah,
look, they got durians. Yeah. They've got hydromelons. They've got volt fruits. I don't think they have dairy out here in the desert.
Makes sense.
So let's. I believe there's milk in Kakariko Village. Let's go there.
Yeah, go watch that video.
Well, actually, I don't think we have that video uploaded anywhere.
I think it's actually clipped. I think it's clipped.
Oh, the chickens might be clipped.
No, but
yeah.
I think I got the highlight.
Okay, though. No milk, but we got butter. We got butter.
Ooh, butter?
Yeah, you need goat butter for stuff.
We need butter for stuff. Yeah, let me buy some butter. I'll take them all. I'm fine with that.
Nice.
Where, nice. Do you have milk in Hateno Village?
Let me look.
Let's go to Hateno. I'm still dressed like a girl. I'm fine with it.
Good.
It's cute.
Yes, she's so beautiful.
Daisy,
yeah. I'm gonna do that thing people love where you like describe a meme out loud. I think people must love that. But it's that scene from Arrested Development where Tobias is like, so Michael, as you may know, Lindsay and I are getting a divorce. And he goes, when did that start? And he goes, I don't want to blame everything on 9/11, but it didn't help. it was that meme, but it was, as you may know, I am bisexual. When did that start? I don't want to blame it all in. I don't want to blame it all on Lincoln Gerudo clothes, but it certainly didn't help.
It certainly didn't help.
Yeah, it's the things in hindsight that you're like,
that's a good one.
Certainly didn't help.
Here we go. Here's milk. Oh, I did one. No, well, I want all of them.
You can get arrows here too. You can get arrows here too.
I do have. Oh, don't whistle. I do have arrows. Are we gonna? I'm gonna need arrows like later, but I don't know if we're hunting anymore.
Okay.
Do I have? This is rice.
Well, you have.
Let me just
them.
Buy some rice while I'm here.
You got a bunch of rice from, yeah.
I got a little bit of rice from fighting that Lionel earlier. I got so many eggs. Ooh. That is an Endura shroom. Ooh, truffles. I don't want to buy truffles. That would be so expensive. And here are some arrows.
So expensive.
We found a truffle on the side of the mountain. Very excited.
You have to use a pig to sniff for it, or do you just like dig
Nope,
them?
you just need to be a beautiful girl from the desert, like me. No, you just find them growing on the sides of trees, or like at the foot of trees. There we go. Okay.
Ooh, nice.
So a wild berry and an egg and milk and wheat.
Been cooking. Oh my gosh.
So, oh, that's an omelet.
Omelet. Berries? Cool.
How did they make an omelet? Why did that make an omelet? Hi. Safsaba. Can I sell you some
Your
stuff?
lipstick. Love it.
I've got things for sale. We gotta sell some stuff. Mainly, I gotta sell you my 490 for a meat skewer. It's pretty good if you ask me. The result of all our hunting, Daisy. It's not bad for just running around on the side of the mountain shooting arrows.
That's pretty good. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, I'll take it. I've got like these are steaks that I had to. I was like real low on health, so I just like started a fire and threw meat in it. I'll sell those. Not bad, not bad. And I got another skewer down there. I'll take 210. Hunting, I love hunting. It's like one of my favorite things to do in this game. Wow, those were very, the meat was very cost effective. Oh, let me sell you some of my gems too. Daisy, how am I doing on money? I can't see because me and Mackenzie's faces are covering that side of the screen.
You got 5,061 rupees.
Does anyone in chat know offhand how much you need to get the final Great Fairy? If you don't, Daisy. 10? 10,000?
I'm on it.
No, I
I
think.
figure it's probably gonna be 10,000. Let me.
10,000.
Oh yeah, it does look like
10,000.
10,000.
Am I close? Am I close? Where am I at?
You're like halfway there.
Oh my God, I'm halfway there. Well,
Yeah, you only have 5,000, seven hundred.
what if the goal now is
To just sell all of the toes that you have.
Toes?
No, I'm not selling the toes. I need these
I need
toes.
the
I need these
toes. I
toes.
need
No,
these
I was going to say, what
toes.
if the goal, okay, so we have the Mackenzie's interview is coming up. And then right after
Yes.
Mackenzie's interview, we have our follower reward mini lecture where we're doing the Cicada Brood X lecture tag
Yes.
team
Yes.
with Kerry and Daisy. What if
Yes.
after for the last hour after the lecture, last 45 minutes or whatever, I try hard as I can to get some more money so you can see at least you and Carrie can see the fairy tonight.
That would be great. I want to see the fairy.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, let's
All right,
I'm gonna
we're
get
gonna
out of
take
this.
like
I'm
a
gonna get out of this suit, to
10
be
or 15
honest.
minute break. Yeah,
Wait, can
we're
I
gonna take like
do
a 10 or 15 minute break. We'll come back.
One more quick appeal?
Oh, yes. Wait. Oh. Ding 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 ring. That's the durian fruit reclamation project phone ringing. Ding 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 ring ring ding
Everyone,
ding
thank you
ding
so
ding.
much for your gift subs and your wonderful support as we cook hearty simmered fruit and get 20 hearts. And I'd just like to say from everyone else at the Durian Fruit Reclamation Project, We're having a wonderful and hearty evening in the land of Hyrule. So as we keep going, trying to get enough rupees to see a thick fairy, we hope that you renew your sub points and do that thing you sometimes do where the guest answers the question right and spam bits. Cause I love hearing that when the guest answers a good question. I hear bring bring bring. It's like the buzzer going off that she did the question right. All right, everyone.
To clarify more on the cicada over harvesting. Part of the reason that Brood 10 only emerges every 17 years is because they emerge in such overwhelming numbers that you can eat them. That predators, I think I read somewhere that like copperheads will stand up on their little snake backs and just stand with their mouths open so that nymphs will fall in.
That is so interesting.
Yeah, that's something that I read, but the thing is that there are so many cicadas that the emergence is designed by evolution to be so overwhelming that they don't die out.
Damn, that's the Soviets in World War II!
See? It's too many cicadas.
The cicadas are going to take Berlin!
Okay. Honestly, the cicadas probably could. There's a lot. But they also, they're designed, that's what they're designed for. Mm-hmm. And the bigger issue is not going to be the over-harvesting, it's going to be construction. There's been a lot of chatter in the, Northern Virginia Reddits about this, that, these regions that were overwhelmed 17 years ago, so they should have cicadas, mm-hmm. aren't having cicadas, and it's because the trees got cleared and construction went up, and new buildings and new housing. So it disturbed the nymphs underground. So the eggs get laid, then they emerge, they burrow underground, they hang out for 17 years, mm-hmm. and then the song and dance continues. If you disrupt that process, that's when you lose the cicada. It's never going to be because we over-harvest them.
Interesting.
Yeah. Oh, interesting.
There are so many things that we only got to touch on, too. And I think, Mackenzie, you're kind of bringing up another... mentioned, really quickly before you asked that question, how you learn how to consume food. That is such an interesting question to me as a folklorist and thinking about foodways. It's not just the food itself and how people eat the food or how they share the food. It's how do you learn to cultivate the food to even turn it into a dish in the first place? So a lot of people are just out there collecting buckets of cicadas and have no idea how to assess for different, diseases, fungus, or whatever, because they saw somebody on TikTok just eat a bunch of cicadas. Right. I'm not trying to say that they're gonna get sick, but the fact that it's become this because it's a cyclical event and is so unique and almost like a festival in terms of excess and consumption, that it's like we should have cicada. It's like we're having cicada festival in these areas almost.
Right.
People think that they're more knowledgeable than they might actually be about how to actually eat prepare this food because they want to do it, but nobody taught them how. Where other people who eat bugs all the time know how to eat the bug. Mm-hmm. It's I don't trust myself to cook meat properly anymore because I've done such little practice of it, but I know where to find answers to do it. But you know what I mean? You have to learn how to do it in order to consume it safely. And that's a big part of food culture and food ways that we don't talk about that much. The knowledge systems of how to actually prepare the thing in the first place.
Oh I think my that's part God, of it. It's Shai Hulud. What the fuck? Oh my god, I did not know I was gonna run into fucking the old man of the desert. Oh my lord.
Oh my god.
Walk without rhythm and you won't attract the worm. Holy shit, I found Shai Hulud.
I don't know, there's just so many... Cicadas are so interesting, and I know that they've kind of been talked to death, so we tried to make our presentation something that you've seen before, but also something... theoretically make an argument to notice something that folklorists might notice that other people aren't noticing readily. So we hope that came across. Flexitron says, hey, can someone explain to me what the sand whale is that Dom is fighting right now? Dom.
You're not a Fremen is not a man until he rides his first sandworm. This is Shai Hulud, the maker of the desert. This is, I don't know, it's Dune, man. Come on, read Dune. It's Dune.
It turned into Dune.
It's literally, my big thing when I read Dune was, oh shit, so everything has just been Dune this whole time? And Zelda, of course, was Dune.
I just read this today, the Greek belief that the cicadas are related to the muses.
Ooh.
How so?
Because they scream.
Nice. Yeah,
so
I love that.
For those of you who are not around Brood 10, and Brood 10 is the biggest. It's the biggest and the baddest of all the cicada broods in the United States. It is a constant hum. It's loud. It is all the time around you. If you go to more of the heavily wooded areas at the parks, you'll get slammed with this wall of sound. It's, you know, the other day, like, I can hear it constantly. Right now I can't because I have headphones on. Windows closed, I can hear the cicadas.
Wow.
Like, they're all the time, and they're the loudest insect species. And so is this idea that they were part of the muses, and they would be born, and then they would sing, and then they would die, and they would go tell everybody what they encountered in their brief time of screeching at the world.
Oh, I love that.
I'm like, all right, cool. Cicada muse.
Walk without rhythm, and you won't attract the worm.
Need worm. So my friend was getting a bunch of gathering cicadas to bring to a friend's house to prepare a meal. And she collected a ton of cicadas, put them in a big Tupperware and put them in the freezer for a day to kill them, basically, so that she could eat them later. Went to the friend's house the next day, took the Tupperware full of cicadas into the car, started to drive. It was like an hour away. And on the drive, the cicadas began to awaken. They had been frozen in the freezer for 24 hours. And they resurrected and started to scream in the back of her car in a Tupperware. And she said it was so terrifying because she thought they were dead, and then they just started screaming in the Tupperware, and it was terrible.
Thanks for the tip, Monatters. All right, now, Mandolin says I can sell this shit.
Damn.
Ew.
Nasty.
Nice.
Oh. Look at all that.
That's fun.
Yeah, they were zombie cicadas. For real.
Ooh. That's from the last person he ate.
Dang.
I'm guessing.
Also, a lot of the things that I read pointed out that it's really hard to measure a lot of the 17-year cicada impacts because it's a 17-year cycle. So the fungus that psychoactive fungus that destroys them is really hard to test because you only have this brief window of opportunity to get the sample.
Mm-hmm.
It's really hard to see the kind of immediate impact of things because it's every 17 years. And it's not like there's any control factor on growth and development there.
Can I read what Flexitron just posted in the chat?
Only if you read it in the song.
Only if you sing it.
Yeah.
Better?
What?
Is that better? Now that my hair is down?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, hair down.
Yes, you gotta do hair down. If you like a little piece.
So hard to do this, but like this?
I know, yeah, well.
All right, ready?
Yeah, that's better. Yeah.
When I was a young bug, my father took me into the soil to see a screaming bug.
He said, son, when you grow up, would you be...
Daisy, I just want to point out you're doing that thing again.
That thing where, that thing where you sing a song and affect like a Brooklyn accent, the way you tried to sing that topiary creature song and your French accent came out Brooklyn. We are the topiary creatures. When I listened to that song and found out it was a guy doing a French voice, I was so fucking confused.
You're like, what the fuck is this? I can't do an accent.
Welcome to the zoo. Zoo.
Yeah, you're right. Why did it sound like I never noticed that before. I needed someone to tell
With
me.
The kangaroos. Rose, Rose.
Rose, Rose, Rose. And the twigas too.
Welcome to Zoo.
I don't remember it as French.
There's definitely
We are the topiary creatures.
It's very nice to meet yous, senors and senoritas too.
Okay, I need an update on the thick fairy search because
need money.
We are very close.
Need
still
money.
Still need money?
Still
How
need
much money?
Oh, still lots more.
Oh, okay.
Okay, because the enduring and greatest moment of Andrew Lloyd Webber's creative career, like, look, it's... I don't care what you think it is. The greatest thing that man ever did was Jesus Christ Superstar.
Hey, I mean, hey, right over my shoulder. Die on that in shot. Right over my shoulder in shot. Do you not see?
I see it.
The original cast recording and the goddamn movie soundtrack too.
I used to have the original cast recording.
Have you not
it's
seen
so
my?
Good.
Yeah, I know I'm not in a basketball jersey this week, but everyone can see my fucking tattoo whenever they want. My Jesus Christ Superstar tattoo.
It's so good. It's such an incredible musical. I could talk about how great it is for days.
Oh, also on my literal shoulder. Yes, we got to that.
Okay, but here's the thing. One thing I want to say about Phantom is that so many opera kids will tell you that he stole and plagiarized a ton of that show. If you really want to do this, like, go back to the operas. Go back to, I think it's Puccini. Just do that. It'll be better. Anyway, great. This outfit looks good. I'm here for the outfit changes.
I got the young gutters. they call me, yeah,
oh
let me
God.
Put on the full barbarian outfit. They call me
oh
young gutters.
Oh no.
This is a good look.
Thank you. Yeet. No, let me get a hammer out.
Can you rate the cats in Cats? We would need images.
Old dude. Oh, that is definitely somebody's tier list. Don't spoil it.
Yeah, it's a certain person's tier list.
The answer is Brian Blessed as the original old Deuteronomy.
Oh, it's so good. And if you'd turn, you would supply. Yes, let's go.
All right.
Wake up. Wake the sleeper has awoken. Oh.
Oh.
Ow.
Oh.
Ow. I thought I was going to outrun that.
Looked like I was very ouch.
It's a little ouch. Ah. Thought I had that. Okay. I got it on this approach. Spin to win. Oh, you
spin
see how we're spinning
win.
To win it out here? Look at
spin,
these. Look
spin
at these.
To win, spin to win,
these
spin
are
win,
minerals,
win.
Marie. Is that a goddamn diamond? That's a goddamn diamond. That's two diamonds.
Hell yeah.
Amber,
we might have won it.
Sapphire. I mean, diamonds are very good for upgrading your shit against guardians.
Oh, yes.
But if it means we gotta sell them. We might have to.
I don't see your.
Wait, this isn't
your,
a rare one? There was still a shit ton of money.
Yeah. I don't see your rupees. Oh, there you go. You got 6,200.
Yeah. I'm a little more than halfway there, but I just... Okay, that wasn't the rare one. Where's the rare one, my guy? Where's the rare one, G? Manatters?
That it's just this entire extended fever dream that is very different in tone, but also not... Like, Portlandia is very much, like, I could see that as, like, David Lynch, but happy.
Daisy, what's my rupee count? What's my rupee count, Daisy?
You do want to know. You got 6,300.
Okay.
It's not going up that fast.
Damn. Well, James told me not to sell the fins, Manatters.
Yeah, now you got 6,871.
Well, maybe not sell the guts, but the fins? Ugh. I'm tempted to sell that diamond. Do I want to sell the diamonds?
Sell them.
All right, it's for Kerry. It's for Kerry.
Do it.
I'll sell the diamonds. I have luminous stones. I can trade for diamonds. It's cool. I was on a fucking what do you call it? Money run. Thousand rupees. Okay. I can find other diamonds if I really need them. Am I selling the guts? That's the question.
We're getting very close.
What are we at now?
You're at 8,171. So we only need 2,000. So
I'm getting so close.
Pretty close.
Okay, so I see there's a talus on the outside slopes of both mountains here. A small and a large. Kerry, what's your favorite video game?
Okay, so I don't play a lot of games.
Five Lexatron.
But the games that I remember playing and took a lot of joy from were...
Hell yeah. Good answer.
Like, Heroes of Might and Magic. The subversion of Might and Magic.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically 2 and 3 iterations. And the game I cannot stop thinking about is Claw. Which was just a running adventure game, like one of those, just you ran through and jumped through all the challenges, but you were a pirate cat.
Wow.
That's who Claw was a pirate cat.
That's pretty cool.
And that was cool. He had a cool hat, and you jumped through weird levels, and it was awesome. And I wasn't any good at it. I was never any good at any of this stuff. I'm terrible at games.
New guy asked us a follow-up question. What's the most emotionally gripping game played? Thought about it for a long time.
Metal Gear Solid 3. Always comes back to Metal Gear.
I was going to say, I can't choose anything. Okay. I've got two answers. I can't choose anything but Dragon Pantser. No, because that was like... just got sucked in whether or not you're playing. That Dragon Cancer was really...
That Dragon Cancer was very, very gripping.
Number two, yeah, I mean, like, that was, like,
amazing. Kerry, when you say Claw, I hope you mean just, like, you were playing a carnival, like, skill crazy game.
I just dropped a YouTube playthrough into the chat. It's genuinely Pirate Cat.
Oh my god.
I gotta get... Okay, so, Northwest Slope. I'm just pointing in this direction and going. I hope. Oh, I didn't do that right. Oh my god. Urbosa's fury is ready. Thank you, Urbosa.
Alright, I gotta run, guys. This was fun.
Thanks
for hanging out with us.
Goodbye, Kerry.
And let me hang out with you guys.
That was good. I don't think we needed each other to put that lecture together. So
you guys needed each other and you did it.
We are under the wire and we did it. I knew we could, but it was right on the wire and
the way
to do it. Yeah.
Down on the wire. Right. I know it's gonna be okay anyway.
Bye, Kerry.
Bye, guys.
Have a good night. Enjoy this.
Yeah.
Hey, new guy neighbor, I found an 8-hour video that is just a cinematic recreation of Final Fantasy VII Remake, which I can't wait to watch.
Loomi has a question for you, Dom.
What is it?
What's the most embarrassing game to cry to? Yeah.
How does one answer that?
I know, I don't know how to answer that, but...
Most embarrassing game to cry to. Probably Pokemon.
Pac-Man.
Kingdom Hearts.
Tetris.
No. That's fair. Tetris is fine. You can cry to Tetris.
Okay, I think there's you could probably get to a level. I'm trying to think, like...
There. Especially if you're playing like Tetris 99. I think I have like not. I might have cried a little bit playing.
If you get to a certain level in the game, and it's like a game that just resets, like that's I can understand crying.
What's like a. Okay, Manatters hopes we have enough money. Thank you, Manatters. Thank you, Manatters.
Yeah.
You
are a, frustration cry does help.
Oh my god, I frustration cried at Hades. Oh. I got like yeah. Bite my lip tear in my eyes playing Hades. I've never hated anyone as much as I hated Hades and Hades. Ugh. I'm saying if you cry in Pokemon, you need to play a real RPG. I said it. If you cried in Pokemon, go play Dragon Quest, you filthy casual. Thank you for your patronage.
All right, getting close.
Oh. Thank you.
Sell you're 20, me all you got. 20 away from 9,000.
It's fucking Lawrence Welk.
500 more.
500 more?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, let's find some monster parts to sell.
Wait.
What?
Yeah, you only need 100 more.
Oh, fuck yeah. Fuck yeah.
So, yeah, I would just sell some extra food or something.
Moblin guts. How many do I need?
4.
We need to play Wolf Among Us again. We got to get Gina back on.
Yeah.
Or get any yes. Another fairy tale scholar on. Oop, just did guts. I had I had a ton of guts.
That was it. You're good.
Oops.
You got 10. You got 10,000. You have 10,001.
Oh, I'm gonna be left with one goddamn rupee. Yeah, we another.
Hell yeah,
we
let's
need to
do
book
it.
A fairy tale scholar and play Wolf Among Us again. I miss
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I agree.
It. Yeah, two, totally. I don't, the two apparently forever in the works. I don't know what's going to happen. Wolf Among Us 2 is going to become the fucking Chinese democracy of video games. I guess that's Duke Nukem Forever. You get what I'm saying. Okay. Daisy.
Yes.
You ready for this? I wish Kerry was here.
Yeah, I know. Me too.
Okay.
Kerry is our model thick fairy. Wish she was here for this. It's okay.
She says I'm obsessed with big women, and I agree. God damn. I like my girls BBW. I could sing the rest, but Twitch TOS.
Hello, I need 10,000 rupee, please. I'm very expensive.
Very expensive lady. All right, I'm ready for this. Are you ready for this?
Oh, yeah. Let's go.
Brum, brum, brum,
you
brum,
are too brum, kind. Brum. Too kind.
The power.
Ah, the power.
Power overflowing.
Bonk.
Yes.
Bonk game.
Show me the thick girl.
I'm bonking Link.
Show me the thick girl. Oh. Ah!
Gorgeous. Gorgeous. Worth the wait. Gorgeous.
Oh my god. Ears.
Wow.
This is... She's beautiful. Oh beautiful. My god. Silver fox. Let's go.
Wow.
This is a, so beautiful. Oh my god. Yeah, this is like, yeah, old fairy, so hype. Let's go.
Yes. Beautiful.
Okay. Cough. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello there. Oh, I'm saying, her name's Tara, but I'm picturing her as the grandma on Gilmore Girls.
Yes.
Oh, have you? Oh. Oh, I'm a
Oh my god, bonk fairy, jeez.
Let's go.
Bonk. Wow.
I've heard you're going to have to bonk this fairy.
bonk.
Oh, can't
my
we?
God!
Can't
oh
we,
my
Tara,
god.
Tara, darling.
Wow.
This is, I'm upset that Rhaenyra Targaryen in House of the Dragon isn't going to look like this.
Oh, I know.
Like, very upset Rhaenyra, yeah. The Rhaenyra is a little too skinny in the show.
I agree.
This lady has ran, started, and produced the same burlesque show for 2,000 years. Oh my God. Okay. I was in Florida one time visiting my parents, and like my siblings and I went to the bar at this restaurant called Marco Polo when we were by far the youngest people there. And we sat at the bar listening to the dude play piano and pan flute. And there was an old lady at the bar. She was in like her 80s, just like very like sun blessed skin, crazy cleavage for an 80-year-old. You know what I mean? She had like a flower between her boobs, and she had like this beautiful husky voice, and she was talking to me and all my siblings, you know, and she was just like, I used to work at Pan Am in the 60s when you had to be attractive. That's who this fairy is.
Wow. That's definitely,
oh my God, fairy. What a love affair. What, oh, a hunk. God. And he's dead now.
Oh my God.
Why don't you show me the clothing you have? All right, let's see if we can enhance something.
Let's enhance.
Okay, so can we enhance this? Oh, we can enhance one of these. We got to kill more Lynels. We got to kill more Lynels on it to enhance this further. Barbarian clothes. Also, wait. We can do the barbarian clothes up one level because more Lynels. We can enhance.
You can enhance the ancient helm.
We can enhance one of them. I do the pants maybe because I wear that with the blue tunic. You know,
right?
Blue tunic. Speaking of,
do blue tunic.
Yeah,
classic.
Yeah,
classic. I don't know. What does everyone think?
Let's do this for a little bit.
Yeah. Let's do.
All right. I hear everyone get the bonk ready. This is from what I've heard.
And close your eyes.
Oh no, that's a level one. We gotta see. We gotta give me something where I can do the level four.
Oh, okay.
But I'm very excited. I'm gonna wear that blue tunic when I fight Ganondorf because he's in the box art wearing it. Let's go.
Oh my gosh. Enhance.
What do I need for that? Shard of Farrash's horn. Okay, Farrash. My favorite boy, Farrash. Okay.
You could do that.
I think I wear this one the most of any item.
Yeah, because the soldiers are... Yeah, because it's your best quality.
It's my best quality, and I just love how it looks. With, like, the red and the light blue. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
What?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no. Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Oh, TOS. 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 TOS.
Oh my
28.
God.
That's nothing to fuck with.
Wow. Oh my God. Oh wow.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. It's scary.
Damn.
Oh my God.
Bonk, lady, bonk.
Do I even dare to keep going?
Can you?
I mean, I gotta do my drip pants.
Yeah, do your drip pants.
Gotta do the drip pants.
Oh my God. Yeah, I think
that's a, you know what that is? You know what that is? I that's a Claudette saying goodbye to Lisa in the room.
Boop. Good night, chat.
Good night, chat.
I definitely have breast cancer. Favorite. Bye, chat.
Favorite villain in games and why? If I already said Metal Gear Solid 3, I feel like I have to say the boss, but I'll think about that. Daisy, who's your favorite villain?
Dang, in games? Okay, let me think about it.
Let me take these all up one. Oh my God. Well, I will say, I think the last boss fight against the boss.
There's definitely a bunch I really like.
The last fight against the boss in Metal Gear Solid 3, I think, is the best last boss fight in gaming history. Also, the story mode in Smash Ultimate, where you have to fight the boss, and it's all white Metal Gear, all white Zero Suit Samus in a field of flowers with a poison effect, and you have to do it in 2 minutes or less. I laughed. I cried. I was just like, you've made Metal Gear Solid in Smash. It was one of my favorite things. Yeah, but I don't know if she's a villain. She's just a well-written antagonist. Villains.
I'm trying to think.
Chat, post your favorite villains.
Oh, I really like Murak in Skyrim.
Guzma.
The Dragonborn.
Ooh, okay.
He's like basically a god that's like really, really bored. I don't know how else to describe him. He challenges you to be the Dragonborn, and he like takes all the souls from you, and he just thinks and that you're not actually Dragonborn, and mm-hmm. he just tries to fuck with you. But I think he's really interesting because he's like reached a level of enlightenment that means that he does have a lot of supernatural powers, but his hubris gets him. All good villains do.
Can I name my favorite villain? I know my favorite villain. When you described that, I figured out who my favorite villain is.
Okay.
And for chat, by Terra, it was a lot. Daisy, I think.
That was thick like fairy. Yeah.
That was thick fairy. I think
12:30. I think it's time to.
Are you good? Pause. Are you good? After I'm watching good. Thick fairy, like.
You mean like, am I okay emotionally?
Emotionally?
The fairy did kind of assault Link.
Yeah. Yeah.
I had to pull out the big bonk stick.
This deserves a huge.
This
bonking.
Deserves a very big bonk stick.
I'm actually very glad that Kerry wasn't there for that.
Yeah, Kerry would never.
Like, Kerry, it's you.
And then like, oh wait, no, Kerry would never do that.
I know.
Unless there was a conversation about it first. Okay.
Making quotes helped me to get a sense of my own space, a sense of finding my way out of my labyrinth.